It was a windy September day when a juvenile humpback was found dead, floating around Chiniac Bay near the city of Kodiak. The whale's corpse was then towed to nearby Puffin Island, a short boat ride from downtown, for the necropsy.
I mean, it's just so lucky that this was spotted and that we were able to actually lasso it and drag it in and then have everybody available at the drop of a hat.
Vendale says dozens of dead whales were reported around the archipelago's communities in 2023, but this is the first one they've been able to dissect and study. He says live whale sightings have been rare.
You know, this summer around Kodiak was very strange because usually you see many humpbacks around and it seems like they just left. They went somewhere else, probably because there wasn't a lot of food around here, so they went to where there was food.
Once the tide is low enough, a team of federal and tribal officials and several volunteers get to work. They measure blubber thickness and take samples of the baleen, which acts like a filter and strains small shrimp, krill, and other foods from seawater. Vandale says the humpback was likely a female subadult, weaned from her mother, but still too young to mate. He says she probably lived a hard life.
There's a bunch of divots along the abdomen, which are cookie-cutter shark bites. You can see healed wounds from previous encounters with orcas on the flippers. So this whale's definitely had been through a lot and survived a lot.
Kathy Burek is a veterinary pathologist with Alaska Veterinary Pathology Services. She says it's unlikely the humpback was killed by a predator because it still has its tongue, a favorite target for orcas. She sees a possible clue in damage around her left eye. Burek says this whale may have been hit by a boat.
It could be some torn tissue like the jaw or the tongue. And then just above it, you can see where there's a very distinct kind of linear area of hemorrhage. So I think we were already getting a feel that there was some kind of trauma.
The team then makes its first cuts to the whale's organs, which they'll sample and test for signs of disease. Vandale says the crew's lucky the wind is blowing and summed up their thoughts on the aroma of a rotting whale's organs.
How do you describe the smell?
Whaley? There's really like nothing else.
Full results from the necropsy samples likely won't be available until late 2024. The scientists say their best guess for now is that the young humpback was too weak to get out of the way of a ship and was struck in the head. This was one of two whales in Kodiak found dead in poor health. Scientists don't know why the animals are struggling, but they hope efforts like this necropsy will offer clues. In Kodiak, I'm Brian Venua.